Just a brief comment about a question we were discussing last day. One of you didn't see how this operator could lead to a vanishing value for the iz component. And in fact, I told you that it should be very easy to calculate the matrix representation of this density operator in the alpha beta basis set. Indeed, it's very, very simple. For instance, this element. This element is alpha rho alpha. That is alpha 1/2 identity operator minus omega j t I x applied to alpha. Let's consider this term. Identity applied to alpha, alpha. Alpha scalar product with alpha 1. So we have 1/2. Then we have what? Constant time alpha ix, which is I plus I minus divided by 2 applied to alpha. This applies when it's applied to alpha gives 0, and this gives beta. So beta times alpha 0. So this term is 1/2. And similarly, we can also find that this term is also 1/2. So in this mixed state, you have the same probability of obtaining positive and negative values for either. And so the average value, the expected value is zero. Well, you can verify that these elements are not non-zero. And in fact, I told you that I have a paper in Journal of Concepts in Magnetic Resonance in which I analyze the physical meaning of this non-diagonal term, that in fact, whenever you have non-diagonal terms in the representation of the density operator in terms of stationary state, alpha and beta are the eigenstates of the Hamiltonian, so they represent stationary state. When you use this stationary state basis set, non-diagonal terms always imply evolution in time. And so in NMR, you always start with an equilibrium density operator in which there is no evolution, because it's in thermodynamic equilibrium. But after applying a series of forces, you obtain a state in which the system is evolving in time, is emitting electromagnetic information that is detected and that is interpreted in that way in the spectra are obtained. Okay? Well, if you don't have any questions, let's go back to finish talking about representation. We start speaking about orthogonalization of basis sets. And I told you that Loving method is the most democratic method because it treats in the same at the same ground all the elements. And so you obtain a basis set in which the new element resemble the old one in the, well, as much as possible. At least the modification is similar for all of them. Right. And right, the idea was that in order to obtain an orthonormal basis set, you have to look for a transformation L such that the new overlap matrix is the identity matrix as correspond to any orthonormal basis set. In learning method, it was the election, and we saw that it works, but this has a little problem. Sometimes when we work with large basis sets, sometimes the matrix, the overlap matrix, has eigenvalues very close to zero. And in such cases, you can have numerical problems for calculating the inverse of the matrix. In fact, it's the square root of the inverse of the matrix. Because in fact, if the matrix has, for instance, in this case we are referring to Hermitian matrix. If an Hermitian matrix has a vanishing eigenvalue, then it cannot be inverted. Because in fact, if you have the matrix in diagonal form, then the inverse can be obtained by simply inverting each eigenvalue, each element. And of course, if one of them is zero, you cannot found it inverted. And so, in fact, basis set should be, by definition, they must be a collection of linearly independent elements.